In this video, we are going to see how we can achieve good position as well as velocity tracking of a mass spring damper system by designing a state feedback controller using pole placement in Simulink. So let us go and see the given problem as well as the step-by-step process we can use in getting this solution. So this is our problem. We were given a differential equation model for a mass spring damper system, and we are tasked with designing a state feedback controller that will drive the system and stop at a position of 10 meters from the origin, and we should also achieve zero steady state error. Also, the state feedback controller should place the closed loop pulse at locations of minus 1 and minus 10. First thing to do is to note your design requirement. We have to convert our differential equation model into a state space model, which have two equations, the state equation and the output equation. The state equation models how the state of the system changes over time as a function of the current state and the applied control input, while the output equation gives a relationship between the output of the system and the state of the system. So D is just the direct transmission matrix that shows the direct influence of the input on the output without affecting the state. So this is not possible usually for mechanical systems because the input and the states are dependent. So for mechanical system, D is usually taken as zero. In order to fully understand the condition of the system, we need two states, that is the position and velocity. So therefore, we define our x1 to be y, which is the position, and our x2 to be y dot, which is the velocity. Therefore, as you can see, x1 dot is just y dot. So substituting this into A leads us to these state equations, which can be represented in matrix form. Assuming that we have full estimate or measurement of our states, our output equation will be this. So basically we have our A, B, C and D matrix as this. So the next thing in our design is to check if it is even possible to design a state feedback controller for this system. For it to be possible, the system has to be controllable and observable. I have already written my A, B, C, and D matrices. So for the controllability matrix CO, we'll use the function CTRB, and the argument it will take is just the A matrix and the B matrix. So this will give us our controllability matrix. So what we have to do is to check the rank of the matrix. So the rank of CO. So it has a rank of 2, which is equal to the number of our states, which means our controllability matrix has full rank and our system is controllable. So the next thing is to check our observability matrix. And it will take the argument A, C. So this is our observability matrix, and then we check the rank. So you can see it also has a rank of 2, which is equal to the number of our system states, and hence the system is observable. So from our MATLAB computation, we can conclude that our system is controllable and our system is observable, and we can go ahead with our design. So this is our closed loop representation. We want to design a gain matrix K that will generate an input U, which will drive our system such that the output becomes equal to the reference. So our U is just equal to KE, as you can see, K times E. And our E is just the reference minus the state. So this is where state feedback controller gets its name. It is called state feedback because we are feeding back the states of the system in order to compute the control input. So substituting U into our open loop state space model, which is given by S dot is equal to AS plus BU, we'll have this equation. So by collecting like terms, we'll have this equation, and our S dot will now be equal to A prime X plus B prime R, and this is our new closed loop state space equation. So state feedback control changes the dynamics of the system. As you can see, our A is now A prime and our B is equal to B prime, which changes the dynamics of the system. So K has the dimension of N by M, where N is the number of control input, which in this case is just one input, which is the pulse applied to the mass spring damper system, and M is equal to the number of states. So basically, our K will just be 1 by 2 gain matrix. And we know that our A prime is just A minus BK. So computing it, because we know our A, we know our B, and we know our K, it will reduce to this. So our A prime would reduce to this matrix. So to compute the eigenvalues or the force of the system, which tells us the stability of our system, we need to solve for the characteristics equation of the system, which is given by determinant of Si minus A prime. So basically we have this equation and it would reduce into this. So this is our actual characteristics equations, but we don't know our K2 and K1 now, which are the parameters we want to obtain for our closed loop system. But we know that we want to place our force at minus 1 and minus 10. So our desired characteristics equation will just be S plus 1 into S plus 10, which is S squared plus 11 S plus 10, which is the desired characteristics equation from our design requirements. So now in order to get our K1 and K2, we just have to compare the actual characteristics equation with the desired characteristics equation. So this leads us to this solution, and comparing the coefficient of both sides, we'll be able to get K1 is equal to 8 and K2 is equal to 8, which you can verify by solving the previous equation up to this stage. Alternatively, you can get the same gain matrix by using the place function in MATLAB, where P is just the desired fault locations. So let us jump to MATLAB and use the place function in computing our K. So let us define our fault location using P. So we want to place our force at minus 1 and minus 10. So now our K, we use the place function and the argument it takes is A, B, and then P. So you can see we have obtained the same gain matrix, and the gains are 8 and 8 as we computed using manual solution. So now let us go to Simulink for the implementation of our closed loop. So here we are in Simulink for the implementation of our closed loop system. We have our gain matrix K if you double click into it. So you have our gain written as K because we have already defined it in MATLAB and Simulink will read it from there. We have our system, which is the state space model, and we just have to write our parameters A, B, C, D, which we are already written in MATLAB. And we have our initial conditions 0 and 0, that is a starting position of 0 and a velocity of 0. Also, we have our reference here, which is a subsystem. If you double click into it, you'll see that we have our definition for position and velocity. So we want it to go to a position of 10 meters and then stop over there. That is, after stopping, the velocity will be 0. So we have like two scopes here for analyzing or tracking the position and velocity of our system over time. So now I just have to run my system. So this is our position tracking. It starts from 0 and then settles at around 8 meters. And for the velocity, it accelerates first of all up to 6 meters per second. And as it approaches the CD state value of the position, it started decelerating up to 0 meters per second. So the velocity tracking, we have achieved 0 CD state error. But for the position tracking, as you can see, our target is 10 meters, but we are settling at around 8 meters. So one of our design requirements is to remove the CD state error in our design. So we have to do something in order to remove that. So let us go back to our design board in order to come up with a solution to this problem. So from our U, you can see that a set feedback controller is analogous to a PD controller. It has a proportional part and a derivative part. So if the steady state gain of the closed loop system is not 1, we'll not be able to achieve 0 steady state error because we are not integrating the error over time. So now we have to design a feed forward scaling term that will eliminate the steady state error. So let us go to MATLAB and see the implementation or the computation of this scaling term. So this is the definition of our matrices for the closed loop system. We have our A prime, which is just A minus BK, and we'll get this matrix. Our B prime is just B times K, which leads to this matrix. And our D prime is just this. So as you can see, it has also changed, and this is due to the fact that for the closed loop system, the reference is the input to the system, and the reference has position and velocity references. So our C will remain the same. So I will define my closed loop system as CLSys, and using SS, which stands for state space model, I will give the argument A prime C and D prime. So as you can see, this is the state space model. So now what I need to do is to compute the DC gain of the system, which will give me an idea on my scaling term. So DC equal to DC gain of CLSys. As you can see, my system has a DC gain of 0.8 in both channels. That is for the position and the velocity. So now all I need to do is to compute a scaling term to the reference that will serve as the feed forward term in order to eliminate my steady state error. So my scaling term will just be KR be equal to the inverse of the steady state gain. So this is my scaling term, 1.25. So let me go back to Simulink and make modification in order to see our new result. So now all you have to do is to complement this system with the scaling term. So let me import my gain. So, and I know my scaling term is just the KR, which I have already computed in MATLAB. So KR, and then I will just apply and then multiply it with the reference. So by doing so and then running the system, you will see that the output is now tracking the reference without any error. So we have removed the steady state error. If you want to see an explanation of PID controller as well as its implementation, manual and automatic tuning in Simulink, watch the video on the right. If you are just getting started with Simulink and you want to be able to design this type of system in Simulink, watch the video on the left. Like and subscribe to the channel if you learn something.